Hi, this is Lance Burton in Las Vegas. I'm so happy you are all getting together to celebrate Jay Marshall's 100th birthday. Jay was a huge influence in my career. Back in 1980, when I won the IBM gold medal competition, Jay took me aside and said, Lance, I love your act, but you gotta get rid of the zombie ball. And I said, what are you talking about, Jay? And he said, you gotta replace it with something more unique. Now that turned out to be the floating birdcage, which was suggested by my friend Johnny Thompson. But it all started with Jay Marshall, and by the time I got to Las Vegas, I was doing the floating birdcage. So Jay, happy 100th birthday. I love you.
Hi, we're Penn and Teller. It's hard to think of one memory for Jay Marshall, or I wish we called him Jasper. We didn't. We should pretend for Jasper, who we love. So every moment with him was a story. Every second was a story. But the first time I remember really meeting him, we probably met him before that, but we had dinner with him. And having dinner with Jay Marshall was to learn what it's like to really be a magician. Every moment, every time he picked up a roll, it bounced off the floor. Every fork vanished, every knife vanished. There was a trick with everything. It's just every second was what a magician should be. It's what a magician should aspire to be. And we miss Jay every day. We miss Jasper, because we always called him that.
We gotta make this fast, because I'm filming illegally here at the Magic Castle, but I wanted to be in the place where I knew that Jay would like it best. So happy birthday, Jay. We love you and we miss you, and happy birthday from all the Larsons. Hi, everyone. Bye.
Whenever you're ready.
Hi, it's Jonathan Pendragon at Cobblewoods, my home in Vermont, where it's a miserable 70 degrees outside. I will never forgive Wessie for dragging me here. I love it. Jay was a man who also was very, very fond of women, like me, famously so. And we were at a convention once, and this very, very, very shapely, attractive 20-year-old, 20-something, maybe 24, I don't know her exact age, walked by, and, you know, Jay's head just completely follows her, and I nudge him, and I go, too young for you, Jay, not for me, but you're getting up there. I'm really giving him a hard time, too young for me, at which time he just turns slowly, looks right at me, and says, well, we'll see about that. He's a god.
Every time I ever performed with Jay in the audience, something went disastrously wrong in my show. It mortified me. Jay loved it. I was once working in Chicago at a club in Oak Brook, and I did the gypsy thread, the gypsy yarn, and something went wrong and it tangled. The only time in my life it ever did, Jay was sitting there. He rushed into the dressing room afterwards and he said, it's that bastard McComb. It's that figure of eight that you're winding. And he took me to the restaurant, we got a chopstick, and he showed me how to really set it up. And a few years later, I was in my living room setting up for a show, making up my thread, and Billy was there and he looked at me with a chopstick and he said, it's that bastard Jay Marshall. Just one of the things I learned from Jay.
Hey, it's Peter Samuelson calling in from Mexico. Just wanted to wish Jay a very happy 100th birthday and to leave a brief little bit of a memory. But there was that one evening when both Jay and Billy McComb were both on the bill at Monday Night Magic back in New York City, and neither one wanted to close the show. They felt that the honor should belong to the other person. So that was a great moment, a great show, and it was wonderful to see the two of them work that out. I know that Sandy was there because I have a picture to prove it. Hey, happy birthday, Jay.
Happy birthday to Jay. It's so wonderful that you're having this celebration, and I just wish my dad was still alive to be a part of it because I loved him very much. So have a wonderful, wonderful party. I love all of you, and I love the Magic community.
Jay's 100th birthday. I've known him better than 50 of that. And when I think back of all the things he taught me, meeting in a three-sheeter meeting, about honesty and uprightness and never cheating or stealing or telling a lie, I appreciate that man for so much. And all I can say in the end is, This is the shortest gratitude song.
Hi, Jeff Hobson here. Let's see, 10 words to describe Jay Marshall. Well, I don't think a dictionary that thick could give enough nouns and adjectives to describe Jay Marshall, but I'll try it in 11 words. 11, one for each of the letters of his name, Jay Marshall. Let's start with J. Jester. Accomplished. Y, I'll get back to you on that. M, magical. A, amazing. R, raconteur. S, shrewd. H, humble. A, astute. L, likable. L, lovable. Oh yeah, and Y. Why? Because we love you, Jay.
Happy Natal's Day, Uncle Jay. I can't believe it would have been your 100th birthday. And to the man who told my mom, don't marry that man, that hot-headed Chinaman, she didn't listen to you. And guess what? I'm in this world. But to be honest, the one thing I could say that I could take away as my greatest memory is that you taught me how to accompany you and Lefty with If I Had My Way. And even though I was 13 or 14 years old, I can still say that it's one of the hardest things to do. Lefty is not the easiest person to work with, right? Anyway, I still play it the same way with the same mistakes as I did when I was that young. And to be honest, it's part of the act. Happy birthday. Wish you were here.
If I had my way. Ready? All set. Throw it into me. All right. If I had my way, dear. Go ahead. Don't rush.
Dear Copper, and I have real great memories of Jay and Francis Marshall over 40 years ago. Of course, sleeping in the library of Jay and getting all the information I wanted on several routines I was working out. It was, of course, a great pleasure.
Hi, this is Simon Aronson, and I'm happy to pay homage to Jay because of all the help he gave me both in magic and in our mind reading app. Back in 1965, when I first got inspired to create a two-person mind reading act, I didn't know where to turn because I wanted to start one on my own. So I asked Jay, and he opened up his library, took me upstairs to all the musty bookcases, and I spent 3 solid days there poring over manuscripts, books, all sorts of things, some of them going back as old as vaudeville. And that access to those materials, some of which might not even exist anymore, was really my inspiration and the starting point for the creation of our act. And I cannot be more indebted to Jay for giving me that start. So thanks again, Jay.
Hello, this is Michael Finney. Geez, who doesn't have a couple of good stories about Jay Marshall? But the truth be told, I met Jay in 1986 at the Desert Magic Seminar, and I was fairly new to the whole world of magic. I got to do my shows, and Jay just was a nice guy, and he liked what I did, and he just became my friend. Truth be told, I really think he liked my wife a whole lot more than he liked me.
Many years ago, Jay Marshall and my husband, Don Lawton, had a very special and very corny MC bit that they always did. So for those of you who remember, I'm sorry, but for those same people, here it comes again. I just want to appeal to you that as you're talking about Jay Marshall, please remember to love and honor him with kindness and most of all, with humor. Love him.
Hi, Stan Allen here in Las Vegas. I had the pleasure of interviewing Jay Marshall live at a Midwest Magic Jubilee, I think it was, in 1995. and he told a story about being in a show on Broadway called Love Life, and he was basically performing a silent act as the overture. And in it, he vanished a bowl of liquid under the cloth on a tray, but he did it by himself, and he just threw the tray off into the wings where a stagehand caught it. One night, he said he misjudged it just a bit, and it hit the leg of the curtain, and the bowl, just by pure coincidence, just spun off by itself into the wings, and the tray landed flat on the stage floor. A miracle. I asked him, what did he do? And he said, well, as soon as the overture was over and his part was done, he ran out into the audience. There wasn't a single magician in the house. Of course. Here's to Jay.
I met Jay Marshall in 1965, and over the years, he became both a friend and a mentor. I used to call him my showbiz Zen master, because I learned more about my profession from Jay than from any other source. So on this, what would have been his 100th birthday, I say, Jasper, here's to you. I think about you every day, and your impact has not only affected me, but hundreds and hundreds of others. Cheers.
Howdy, it's me, Matt King, and I just want to say I wish I was going to be there when you unearthed Jay's body so that you can put a hat on his head and wish him his 100th birthday. So happy birthday, Jasper, and you look great. It's me, Matt King, in my opulent dressing room. I'm one of the shittier, more expensive acts.
Jay Marshall lives forever.